Hello ladies and gentlemen, ZPro here bringing you another Minecraft Modern Warfare Vehicle tutorial. In this tutorial we will go ahead and build the Leopard 2A4. The Leopard 2 is a main battle tank developed by Cross Maffei in the 1970s for the West German Army. The tank first entered service in 1979 and succeeded the earlier Leopard 1 as the main battle tank of the German Army. It is armed with a 120mm smoothbore cannon and is powered by a V12 twin turbo diesel engine. Various versions have served in armed forces of Germany and 12 other European countries, as well as several non-European nations including Canada, Chile, Indonesia, Singapore, and Turkey. The Leopard 2 was used in Kosovo with the German Army and has been seen action in Afghanistan with the Dutch, Danish, and Canadian contributions to the International Security Assistance Force, as well as seen action in Syria with the Turkish Armed Forces. There are two main development batches of the tank, the original models up to the Leopard 2A4, which have vertically faced turret armor, and the improved batch named the Leopard 2A5 and newer versions, which have the angled arrow-shaped turret, applique armor, together with other improvements. All models feature digital fire control systems with laser rangefinders, a fully stabilized main gun, and coaxial machine gun, and advanced night vision and sight equipment. Yeah, so the Leopard 2A4 here, one of the, pretty much the last variant of the Leopard 2, which featured the vertical kind of front turret. If you look at the newer versions of the Leopard, like the 2A7, 2A5, they have a very kind of pointed front of the turret there. So the 2A4 was the last one to kind of make use of that. Again, the 2A4, really nice. I personally kind of think the 2A4 looks better compared to the newer Leopard, but I mean that's just kind of my personal opinion. I'm sure there's somebody here which will want to, you know, murder me for that. But anyways, really cool tank, and it's been a long time since we visited modern Germany, and it's been requested for a very long time that I do a Leopard 2. So yeah, we have the Leopard 2A4 here, really nice design, and is gonna go great with any of your modern German militaries, and as I mentioned before, it's seen service pretty much all across the world, so we can see a introduction to a lot of different environments. Let's go ahead and take a look here at the vehicle, see exactly where we go ahead and building, and then we'll kind of move into the tutorial from there. So obviously starting off with, we have the main gun, 120mm gun, the front armor here. The Leopard is a pretty simplistic tank in the sense it's got just a lot of flat surfaces, a lot of just smooth slopes and all that. And that's pretty much what we got going on here. Driver's hatch, viewports, obviously the little optics, stuff like that here for the turret itself. As we move back further, we have the two hatches here. We have one hatch over here for the gunner and one over here for the tank commander. As we work our way back further, we got smoke grenade dispensers and basically the rest of the turret here. On the side, it's just a basic Leopard 2 side armor and the rear engine and all that. So overall, a really nice looking tank, pretty simple in design and pretty nice and straightforward build. So again, will be a great build for any of your modern conflicts. Anyways, let's go ahead and start with the tutorial by beginning with our first layers 0 and 1. All right guys, going ahead and moving into our first layers here, I'm going ahead and start with layers 0 and 1. Now for these layers here, to go ahead and get started with, we're going to place down a green terracotta block like so. From that green terracotta block, we're going to place down a green shulker box to the side. Now come off those blocks toward the direction of the front of the tank, we're going to place down two narrow brick ups downstairs. We're going to go to the side here of the shulker box, dark oak button, item frame, and a green terracotta block in that item frame. We're going to then go to the block in the ground here, we're going to place down two narrow brick blocks in the ground just like that. After we have that done, we're going to basically build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 more road wheels. So you're going to have basically a total of 7 here for the tracks of the tank. So for this, we're going to place down green terracotta block, shulker box, then 2 blocks here in the ground, and we're going to go and basically repeat that a total of 4 more times. So green terracotta block, shulker box, 2 blocks in the ground, and that's going to be 1, 2, 3, and then we have 4, our last row, and our fourth one. We're going to place down a row of narrow brick blocks as well. So we currently have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm miscounting, it's actually going to be 7. So we're going to place down one more green terracotta block, shulker box. On the tops here of each one of these blocks, we're going to place down item for dark oak wood buttons, item frames, and then green terracotta blocks in those item frames like that to finish off the wheels. We then want to go and go the spaces in between the green terracotta blocks, and we're going to just very simply place down dark oak with top slabs, just like this, along those spaces. Now once that's done there, we're going to go to the back section here and place down two narrow brick slabs, and then two narrow brick top slabs coming off those slabs. We also want to go ahead and take our dark oak with top slabs. We're going to go to these narrow brick slabs here, we're going to place down three dark oak with top slabs over. And on the back here, we're going to place down one dark oak with top slab back. So I'll be hitting coming off of it, and then a dark oak with fence gate, like so, to both sides here, coming off those dark oak with top slabs and down the back. Then going up to the front here, we're going to go ahead and stop, or we're going to go to the what is going to be the green terracotta block here. We're going to place down three dark oak with top slabs over, and we want to go just fill in the space in the across the bottom here with dark oak with top slabs, basically closing the whole bottom of the tank off like so. Pretty simple stuff, just like this. After that's finished, we're going to go ahead and basically, from this point, go ahead and take dark oak with trap doors, which we'll grab. And we're going to place down row 3 across the front here. Now, after that, we're going to then take our narrow brick stairs, and we're going to basically copy the same track design just over here to this side. So I'm going to go with this a little bit faster, as I've already kind of covered in detail how to do this. Again, just refer to the air side if you do get a little lost. It's, again, you know, nothing too crazy to do. And we're just going to take this, run this all the way back to here. We're going to place down our two narrow brick slabs, so 1, 2. And our two top slabs, just like that. And of course, we're gonna fill the space in. If I do go fast, feel free to slow down the video or go over to the other side and just copy that. Kind of straightforward stuff here, as I mentioned, I kind of covered in detail the other side to do it, so that's why I'm kind of doing this a little bit quicker. And our green terracotta blocks and our dark liquid top slabs, like so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just like that, filling that space in. And anyways, taking a look at it from up above here, this is what you should have for layer 0-1. Creates a nice base here for the tank, and basically from this base here, we're going to build the rest of the layers. Anyways, let's move on to layer number 2. Alright guys, moving on to our next layer, we have layer number 2. For layer 2 to go ahead and get started with here, we're going to place down a green terracotta block in this spot right here, followed by a green shulker box coming off the side. Same thing over here to this side as well, just like that. Space in between these green terracotta blocks, we're going to place down a row of 3 of blocks across, and then we're going to place down 2 narrow brick stairs coming off both sides like so. In the space across the middle between these narrow brick upside down stairs, we're going to place down a row of, or sorry, a narrow brick stair here in the middle, and then to both sides of that narrow brick stair, we are going to be placing down a dark oak wood stair like that. Coming off the 2 dark oak wood stairs, we're going to place down item frames, and in those item frames, we're going to place down snowballs for the front headlights. From this point, we're going to then place down a zombie head, which is going to be going on the side of this green shulker box, to both sides. We then want to take our green terracotta. We're going to place down a row of 1, 2, and 3 green terracotta blocks, and same thing over here, 1, 2, and 3 green terracotta blocks. So we can go and fill in the space here in the middle. You don't have to. You can leave it open for a little bit of an interior if you do want to, but for the tutorial, we're just going to go ahead and fill it in to make it nice and solid. And then on the ends here of these rows of 3 of green, the rows of the green terracotta blocks, we're going to go ahead and place down 3 mossy cobblestone walls. We're going to place down another row, going all the way across here, filling the space in, and this row here is going to have a zombie head to both sides. At this point here, we're going to go ahead and basically place down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blocks back. Same thing here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 blocks back. Followed by a dark oak wood upstand stair to both sides, and on the sides of the stairs, we're going to place down a dark oak wood sign, like so. We can go and then fill in the space here in the middle, basically completely fill in the inside here up of the tank, and close this off. Again, there is a lot of interior space for this build, so if you do want to build an interior, you're more than welcome to. We just won't be doing that in the tutorial itself. So just like that, and we can go and then grab dark oak trapdoors and place them down along the sides here of these green terracotta blocks and make sure they're all closed so that they look face downwards like so. Same thing over here as well, just like that. After that's done, we want to go ahead and then go to our next row here. We're going to place down a row of 5 green terracotta across the middle here, a green shulker box to both sides, and then coming off that shulker box, we're going to place down a dark oak button, followed by a item frame, cobweb, and then we're going to go over here and do the same thing. Dark equip button, followed by a item frame and a cobweb, just like that. After that's complete, we're going to go ahead and then place down a row of dew, Nurburg stairs on top of those two Nurburg top steps, just like that. Space here in the middle, we want to go ahead and place down a mossy cobblestone wall. In the center here, followed by a spruce wood upside down stair to both sides of it. Coming off the mossy cobblestone wall, we're going to place down an item frame, green terracotta blocking the item frame, and a dark equip sign coming off the side of the mossy cobblestone wall, just like that. And once we have that done, that's pretty much the main structure of the build complete. We're going to be going ahead and moving into making a few banners here for the build. Again, these banners are pretty simple. They're just basically here for us to basically make the rear brake lights and kind of add a little bit more to these back kind of fenders or mud flaps, whatever you really want to call them. So for this, we're going to go ahead and go into our create a menu, and we're going to go and grab ourselves a loom. We're also going to go ahead and need... three black banners, and we're going to need some green dye, two red dye, and two yellow dye. So for these banners to begin with, we're going to start by placing down our loom. We're going to go into our loom with our first banner. We're going to place down a green dye piece, and we're just going to go and select the top portion that breaks it kind of in the thirds here, so just this top portion like that. And we're going to place this down on the insides here, these inside stairs, just like that. Our next banners here are going to be obviously slightly different. We're going to go into our loom. We're going to take our block banners. For our first one here, replace red dye. We're going to select the red dye square over here on the left side, on the top corner. And we're going to then switch to yellow dye. And we're going to then select the right corner with the yellow dye. So we get a banner that looks like this. We're going to basically do the same thing here for this banner, just this time the complete opposite. So yellow in the top left and red in the top right. And we have these two banners. For these banners, real simple, we want the yellow facing toward the inside. So this banner here and this banner here on that side. And as you can see, we basically have our hazard and brake lights here on the rear and our kind of mud flaps on the back, all complete. Anyways, that again right there is going to wrap up this layer, and with that, let's go and move into layer number 3. Alright guys, moving into our next layer, we moved into layer number 3. For layer 3, we're going to start by going ahead and going to the narrow brick stairs. We're going to place down redstone repeaters on top of those stairs, and we're going to separate the notches as far as we can get them, so just like this here for both those stairs. After that, we're going to take daylight detectors, place down a row of 7 all the way across here. We're going to go and then place down a row of 7 of dark liquid slabs across. And then we're going to place down a row of 7 of dark liquid stairs. Now once we get to this point, we're going to go ahead and then go to the sides. We're going to place down an end rod on top of these zombie heads here. And then we're going to go after the end rod, place down 1 and 2 zombie heads on the side of the slabs and stairs. So just like that. Once that's done, we're going to take our green terracotta. We're going to place down another row of 7 across. And we're going to go ahead and then go to the sides here, place down a lever, have it flick downwards like that to both sides. We then want to go ahead and go back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, green terracotta blocks, and same thing over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can go ahead and then fill in the space here in the middle, just basically close this off. Again, you do have interior space, so you can put an interior if you want to. We get to this point, we're going to go ahead and then place down a black concrete block here on both sides, followed by a ladder, like that. And then a row of 5 green terracotta, filling that space in. And then we're going to place down 2 spruce wood planks back here on both sides. And again, 2 rows of 5 green terracotta fill in the middle space. We're going to place down a row of 7 of green terracotta across. And we want to go and then place down another set of 2 spruce wood planks going back, like so, on both sides. And again, we're going to fill in the space in between them with green terracotta. Across the back here, we're going to place down another row of 7 of green terracotta, and we're going to place down ladders along the sides there, just like that, going all the way across. Now, once that's all done there, that is going to wrap up this layer. So, pretty simple, straightforward layer. And with that, let's move into layer number 4. Alright guys, moving into our next layer, we're moving into layer number 4. For layer 4, to go ahead and get started with, we're going to place down a zombie head here on top of these 2 end rods, just like this, to both sides. After that's done, we're going to then place down a spruce wood slab, which is going to be right here. And we're going to then place down a zombie head coming off the stair, and then one here to the side of it, just like that. After that's complete, we're going to then go back from this. We're going to place down a row 3 of green terracotta across like this. A item frame with a black concrete block over here on the right side. And after that, we're going to then go to the middle block. And we're going to place down a dark oak top slab in the middle. Smooth sandstone top slab. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 dark oak top slabs going forward. We're going to place down a zombie head here on the slab there on the front. And we're going to then go to the third and fourth slabs. And we're going to place down dark oak signs here on the sides. After that's complete, we want to go ahead and also place down a item frame over here to the green terracotta block on the left side of the tank, and then we're going to place down a black bed in the item frame, rotate around, so it looks like that. From this point here, we're going to go ahead and then place down a mossy cobblestone wall on both sides of this row of three, and then we're going to place down a dark oak button on these two blocks, green terracotta block here, and a item frame here and a green terracotta block in the item frame. Same thing over here to this side as well. We're going to then place down a row of row of five blocks across, a second row of five, and then a third row. On both sides of the third row, we're going to place down a dark oak sign. Little space here, we're going to place down a row of three of green terracotta blocks, a dark oak upside down stair here to both sides. We're going to then place down a row 3 of dark oak upside down stairs and a dark oak top slab. A dark oak stair in the middle here and a corner stair to both sides. So it should look like that there on the back. After that, we're going to place down a row of 5 of green terracotta, dark oak top slab across, and then another row of 5 directly after it. We then want to go ahead and place down a row of 1, 2, 3 dark oak trapdoors and 1, 2, 3. After that, we're going to go and place down a row of 1, 2, 3 daylight detectors and 1, 2, 3. And in the very middle here, we're going to place down a spruce wood slab. Our next row here, we're going to place down a a daylight detector, followed by two narrow brick slabs, daylight detector, and then two narrow brick slabs and a daylight detector. We're going to place down a dark oak slab here in the middle, two narrow brick slabs to both sides, and a dark oak slab to both sides as well. After that, place down a narrow row 7 of dark oak slabs coming all the way across here, and just make sure that if your daylight detectors here do interfere with your trapdoors, you make sure you close them back up. And with that, that is going to wrap up what we have there for layer number 4 for the build. With that, let's move into our final layers here. Layers 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going to basically put the top of the turret on and all that stuff. So with that, let's go ahead and move into our final layers. I guess moving into our final layers, we have layers 5 through 10. For these layers, to go ahead and get started with here, we're going to place down 1, 2, 3 green terracotta blocks on the front here, 2 dark oak wood trapdoors, 1, 2 green carpets, a birch wood trapdoor, and then a dark oak wood trapdoor after that. We're going to then place down a dark oak wood slab, followed by a second slab here to will be the left side of the tank. We're going to go ahead and then place down a zombie head on this mossy cobblestone wall at a slight angle like that to the side, and also on this one also to the other side as well. After that's done, we're going to then place down a sandstone slab here in the center, and we're going to then place down a spruce wood slab to the right side, followed by a dark wood slab, and then 1, 2 dark wood slabs over here. We then want to go off the slab, place down a item frame, and a black concrete block in the item frame, and a dark oak sign over the item frame like that. Once that's done, we're going to then place down a row of 5 of dark oak stairs across, and we're going to then place down a second row of 5 of green terracotta across, a second row of 5 of green terracotta. When we get to this point here, we're going to go to the sides. We're going to place down 1, 2, 3 green shulker boxes back, and 1, 2, and 3. We're going to then place down 1, 2, 3 green terracotta blocks, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3 filling in the middle spaces like so. To the sides here, we're going to be going ahead and grabbing our nether bricks stairs. We're going to place down 1, 2 here, and a wither skeleton skull come off that stair. And over here, 1, 2 nether bricks stairs and a wither skeleton skull. We want to go ahead and also place down dark oak signs here on the sides of the stairs. And over here as well, we're going to do basically the same exact thing. And we're going to then place down a dark echo trapdoor, come off the side here of this sugar box to both sides. On the very back here, we're going to place down a monster cobblestone wall on the right side. Two dark echo trapdoors here. Two dark echo trapdoors coming off those trapdoors, kind of opened like so, so it kind of creates a little bit of a box there. We're going to then place down a green terracotta block here with a zombie head coming off of it, and a monster cobblestone wall in this section, followed by again a zombie head coming off that monster cobblestone wall. Now going up from those mossy cobblestone walls on the back here, we're going to place down a dark oak with fence post to both sides, and then 1, 2, 3, and 4 iron bars going up like this, and 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to now move into the top turret details. So for this to go ahead and get started with here, we have a lot to choose from to do. But we're going to go ahead and start off by going to this block right here. We're going to place down a mossy cobblestone wall on it, followed by an item frame and a black bed in the item frame like that facing forward, and a dark group with sign on the side of the monster cobblestone wall. We're also going to place down a zombie head here on top of the stair. And then from that, going back from this zombie head, we're going to place down a second one, a spruce wood slab, and on the blocks around the spruce wood slab, we're going to place down zombie heads like so. We're going to go ahead and place down our spruce wood slab here, and we're going to do the same thing. So for the cupola here, zombie heads again around, and we want the zombie head faces facing toward the outside to kind of give the idea of kind of like the slits here for the optics or the viewports, which are around the cupola. Once that's done, we're going to go ahead and place down a iron bar on this green terracotta block here, and we're going to go ahead and then place down a item frame on this green circle box here with a green terracotta block in the item frame, and also a dark oak wood button on top of the shulker box as well, like that. Over here on the opposite side, we're going to go ahead and grab levers, and we're going to place down one and two levers like this, have them facing toward each other like so. Now one thing we can also add here is the optional MG, which is mounted here. It's pretty simple, it's kind of smaller, well I say smaller, but basically a 7.62mm MG, so nothing really too crazy, but it's a weapon you guys can add if wanted. Just kind of adds a little bit more to the build, and all that stuff. So again, kind of up to you guys. But basically for this, to go ahead and build this, we're going to place this zombie head here with a dark oak wood fence post. On top of it, we're going to place down a nether brick upside down stair with a end rod coming off that stair like so. On the right side here of the stair, we're going to place down a dark oak wood sign, item frame, and a black bed in the item frame, rotated to face forward like so. And we're going to place down a redstone repeater on top of that nether brick upside down stair, a dark oak wood top slab here to the left side, and a powered rail on that slab. We want to make sure that the power rail is also kind of facing so it looks like the belt is running into the gun like so. And then lastly, for the back here, we're going to go and place down a spruce wood upside down stair like that to go and make the back there of the gun. And once we have that all complete there, that is going to wrap it up for my design here for the Leopard 2A4 main battle tank. Hope you guys do enjoy this design and are able to put it to good use. If you do want to use this build, I do ask you guys give me proper credit for it. This would be a link from a solid build to my channel or this video if this does appear on social media sites. As long as you guys give me proper credit for it, you're free to use it for whatever project you guys are working on. Overall, enjoy the build, have fun with it, and all that fun stuff. But other than that, that's going to do it for this tutorial. Thank you guys again so much for watching. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. It's been Derek204, and I'll see you guys next time.